I have 6 expectations. 1. There is a tremendous amount of price change or variations, fluctuations that are happening in the metal and the plastic prices, commodity prices, in the past 8 months or so. While some of it is international phenomena, my request is that there should be a government intervention to bring some stability into these prices, to bring in more confidence. 2. My expectation is that the long pending labor reforms should be put into action by the government from this year onwards. It's much required for the industrial health. The third area which I expect the government to do is towards creating an export-led economy is that identify companies that have products and brands which are internationally competitive and provide some conscious encouragement to help them grow internationally. 3 other areas that I would like to talk about is EV, both the vehicles and the charging infrastructure. I expect government to play a more active role in EV adoption and for creating the charging infrastructure within the cities and across the highways. The second area where we are doing pretty well already is solar, but I expect the government in this budget to bring in some policies that can encourage solar rooftop investment across commercial industrial spaces and the government buildings, and I expect uniform policies across various states. Another request to the government would be to support all commercial industrial infrastructure where energy saving investment has been specifically made. This support should not just be in terms of the ratings, but also in some form of fiscal incentives which will encourage companies to adopt more energy saving measures.
For the budget, we have made 3 asks. Like I mentioned, we've asked for a predictable tariff policy.
Right.
And secondly, we've asked that in the bill of entry, there needs to be provision for the importer to file his maximum retail price. So the government has a monitoring mechanism at the time of import, at what price they are importing the product on the invoice, and what is the price they will be charging the consumer at the MRP level. And the third area that we are seeking over there is that the drug inspectors at the ports need to start looking at the quality of what's coming in, and in terms of compliance with the Drug Act, start doing an informal check. Right now, we still have 1.5 years time to have the enforcement of the Act, because currently it's under the voluntary registration regime. But once they start knowing that what quality they have to achieve, they would start knowing that what kind of testing laboratories are there or not there in the country, and the infrastructure is planned and created for that.
Government should reduce the interest rate and bring it on the par with home loans.
Thanks.
Number 2 is timely and adequate finance for the MSME. 3rd is policy should be liberal, less cumbersome, and implement labor laws has to be relaxed. Then government should give incentive to small scale industry to grow, not only to large industries. Then government should allow the small industry to diversify in various fields, make policies which are conducive to them, and discuss with them on a quarterly basis what needs to be done to grow further.
The only thing which budget can do to us is actually rationalization of duties and levies. Because if you see in last 3-4 years, the duties and taxes on coal and coal transportation has increased manifold. And along with the adequacy of power, reliability of power, we need to keep in mind the per capita income of Indian households. We need to ensure that power is affordable. And for that, the cost of procurement has to come down.
We are expecting big announcements for the infrastructure investment, including in the power sector. And IMA has also made suggestion for the budget 2021, which includes some provision of chapter 98 for concessional basic custom duty under HNSS code 9801, under chapter 98, which is obsolete now. The other suggestions we have given is to reduce the basic custom duty on primary aluminium from 7.5% to 5%, so that there is a level playing field for both the secondary manufacturers and end consumers can be ensured. Made the suggestion to government to again implement the 200% reduction on R&D, which earlier was, so that new technology development can be in. The government of India also support and promote various clusters. Now they have also come out with making some incentives for cluster manufacturing, so that we can be more productive and we can be most cost competitive.
But I think if you really want to kick this in, right, if you really want the industry to be self-dependent, if you really want the country to be self-dependent, this is high time where the industry, where the government actually, you know, make laws in such a way that benefits our Indian manufacturers. And my only advice to Indian manufacturers who are in this solar panel, because majority of them are good friends and they're like family, is that start building technology in India. It's high time. Right. When you say make in India, it's not make in India, it's assemble in India. Let me put it in context. The government has been concerned in terms of budget. I think it should be very, very strongly for small businesses also. And I'll explain what I mean. The government should really take into consideration ensuring that small businesses are secure, right? Whatever damage has happened, of course, the government has come with moratorium and things like that.
Government should now encourage stakeholders by providing some sort of, you know, the tax benefits to the product suppliers who are into green products and green manufacturers. So some sort of, you know, the maybe GST compensation or some tax rebates. Like, we are service consultants, a green consultant. We are also paying GST. Right. And we also, you know, if we get also some sort of incentive, so we can encourage more builders.
Okay.
And let's hope it is a part of the budget.
Yeah, budget, I think, number-wise, it has to be good, no doubt, for the farm sector, looking at the mood of the farming sector at the moment. But more than numbers, it is the policy which will play an important and crucial role.
You are actually doing very important in the value addition. We want to go up the value chain. And this is very important for India. And this is where I see also a huge benefit of the free trade agreements. And that is why the EU-India free trade agreement can certainly benefit India also in increasing their value share, because when you have more, you are doing more R&D work,
right,
you are doing more value addition. This can really help and benefit the India.
What I would like to hear is more on the manufacturing sector. How we can include more manufacturing, how we can include more self-reliance, how we could hear more on skill development. Because these are the something, yeah, if you allow these manufacturers who are has 100% EOU, they cannot sell their material domestically. So if they, if you allow them to, certain percentage can be allowed to be sold domestically, we will be saving the export and the import duties. That is substantial amount of money, because ultimately it is our own money, Indian currency, which is going out and coming back in. I mean, it's like, you know, doesn't make sense.
Sort of ensure that there's a uniform GST rate on all the auto component. We suffer two GST rates, one at 18% and another at 28%. Almost 60% of our items are at 18%, while the rest is at 28%. So if the government can make it a uniform rate, that would be very, very great, because, you know, we have an aftermarket where, you know, suffers from gray market. And that's because of the high rate of taxation. So we're only looking for if the rate of uniform GST would be very conducive to the industry. And that apart, there are certain procedural issues which are very mundane in that sense. Nothing very a big ask, but just that if the GST rate could be made uniform also in the budget, if there could be incentives growth or let's say, we believe that the government has done very well when it comes to addressing supply side challenges, but if there could be incentives for creating demand in the automotive sector, that could be really very, very helpful.
to a developer, if he gets a fast track clearance as far as the various government clearances are required, as when he is going to take up some development, then it kind of converts into money, because the time that he saves in terms of getting those clearances, it helps him to benefit in terms of the money. You know, it can be easily converted into monetary benefits. So that is one. Secondly, as I said, that there have been instances where government has been providing some SOPs as far as your manufacturers is concerned, if there is, you know, on taxes and all that, reduced taxes on green products. So there are those things also which are there.